But in this instance, PMI. Yeah, these three fingers. Yeah, and then you let it roll. So ta ta ra pam ti ha ta do ti ha. I M P M I. As you have it here, you can do it before as well. That will make it a little bit easier. And then it has to move. It has to have that direction forward, right? So the some of the fingerings, but mainly the sort of like this right hand technique that lacks the preparation and efficiency is what is stopping you from getting the tempo and getting the dynamics. It's not in your muscles. You can do it. It's in here. That you would be able to control it. All right. Let me check one more thing. Ah. No, it's not this section. Actually, give me this. That's the same. Do it again. And then you go.
Yeah.
This is odd, this transition here. So what I would suggest to you, bar. Yeah. And the hand is in the same position for this chord, and you won't have problem coming from there. It's easy. But this is easier, this transition here. Then this one there, okay? So right here, go to the second position instead. All right, same thing. Okay, playing this. What is that? You play it here on. Play it again. Chest forward, secure more the bar. When you play this. Put the thumb on the string. Maybe now. Hold on. What is that? Again. This one doesn't come down. That's it. Do it again. Feel that? Add two more notes. What is it? So that it doesn't go wobbling. Remember the feeling. That's it. Put two groups together. There you are. You see? It's within the grasp. You're just not using it. That's great. This one. That's not, you know what, I want that you play with it such a strength that the guitar cannot take it. That's it. It has to have another thing, left hand. Give me this. That's it, that's where the pinky has to be. So don't make it go far away in order to get more sound. You don't need that. There you are. So rein in that one as well. Let's go on right there. Go bad. Playing with that is that. Okay, playing. Go for it. Go play me forte. You're thinking each note. Again, think reflex. Play me first chord, first four 60 notes. Do you play PIMA? What, how do you do that? You're not securing this with the chest, with the whole body. This has to feel like so solid, and this has to be. Yeah, a little bit. No, when you go into that chord, it's sort of like. Yeah. Now you're plucking each note. You are like you're telling me a story, but spelling every letter. You know,
yeah.
A O N S C E. Instead of saying once upon a time, I'm hearing each spelling. You know, I have to figure it out. This way, yaga daga daga daga. Ah, but then it's slow. So play me only this. Again. It's slow, right? Relax the fingers, relax the fingers. What do you feel?
Tension
in this one?
Mm-hmm.
Is that only in the combination with this finger or in combination with this
one?
With this one also? Play me high. Then play me. Play me tremolo. No. Both times. So this is not our approach, which is workaround.
Mm-hmm.
Like if you feel a tension here and this one is not returning, find a different fingerprint. So with a tremolo. No, you're playing one too many. Hold on. Play me one tremolo unit, one burst. Yakataka. Yeah, there's too much time between P and A. Decisively. Yakataka. Don't tense into these three. That's it. Even more, even freer. Physical push. But more with the sense of what we did before. Play me this. There it is. No problem there, right? There we are. Matter of finding it. Next group of tremolo. No? Replay. Don't think each finger. Now, next three.
No, but that one, I was doing this.
What? Yeah, PMI, I know. So give me three. Don't buzz. Again. And then two. No. The last one is. Sorry. PM. PM. Yeah, so I'm working. Grouping this into a sort of like mechanical, easy reflex grooves that your hand can execute with that sense of ease. Next one. No, three. Again. No. What did I do? 4, 4, 3, 3, 2.
Okay.
Right? Because every one of those will start with thumb. But I won't play me the first four notes. Next four notes. Next three. Next three. Next two. Those are your grooves. Okay? Play them again. Even more time in between, but more sense of reflex. Follow after me. Itself in, right? And you seek it. It's not something that just comes. For some people it does, you know. But you, for you, for many, and for me also, you know, I'm seeking that mode of playing intentionally. Becomes, you know, you have a music as a, how to say, your primary guide, mm-hmm. right? And all these other steps are behind it that leads to the final goal. And the final goal is there's a ya da 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 da. And you feel that rhythm, right? And you can do that, like rhythm or something like that. But that's the idea. This, everything else that we were talking here, was just sort of like execution of it. Play me this, without the how do you say, without the chord, but play me the whole rhythm like that.
Okay, so...
No, no, everything is the thumb. Da 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 da. Thumb is on the... There you are. And that strength that we talked about, that... And then another thing that will have to be there is that preparation of your thumb. And reining it in so it doesn't go too far away. That's what... That, you see, that gives you that sense of insecurity. That's why you are thinking a lot while you are playing. And that's why it's a little bit about apprehension. And when you work on this to rein it in, to get that more, how do you, tuned up, everything else will flow better. All right? Let's go to one more section I want to... For example, this one, yeah. Play me these strong notes when you begin here. Thumb here, right?
Yeah.
Can you bring the? I like, except that I would. Can you try to bring the thumb on that, on this one as well? Play me the first note, just. Okay. Now start this whole thing with the thumb. No.
Just
but with the whole fingering that follows. P M I, M I. On the Fs, leave the thumb on the fourth string. But also exchange the, instead of just doing PI, exchange it with PI, PM. Yeah. That's it. It will give you even a little bit more of flow. Yeah. Because you have sometimes, you know, sometimes these notes, like for example here, you have three in a row. And I would want you to this one last to play PMI. Just this one. Feel that? Three fingers, if possible. Because these three are in a row. After you have a slur, that's fine. But yeah, before that are slurred, so you don't have problem with this one. MP, it will be easier because it's always easy to exchange the opposite motion than these two. Right? So rework this around Something like that. I think this would work. That's it. You're a little bit more agile. You feel it already. Also, the very one, this first note, you're playing it with A finger rest stroke. What about if you give me an M finger on that? It's a little bit more massive, a little bit better sound. A tends to be a little bit bright, right? And that's the same. When you go on to this one, seek the good tone. Yeah, there you are. That's it. Give me this section. You know what? Slur this one. Ta-da-da-dam. Slur this one as well. Back onto the reflex mode. Play me first three groups of three notes. Da 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 da. Okay? Play them together. Do not staccato it there, but what I want, look at my right hand. So every time I pluck, my fingers are preparing on the next string. Shorter, even shorter. I need to hear this. That's it. You feel that?
Yes.
Give me one group. And then. There is again, you laughed, and now I laugh back at you. You just did it. Do it again. There you are. Yeah. Next group, start with the thumb as well. PI. There you are. PP. Da da da. PI. MI. MI slur, M slur, rest stroke. Not that one. Both.
So both this and this one.
Because again, you will have PIM as a group. Because you're coming from here. You have now four groups of PIM, PIM, PIM. Do that again. There you are.
Yeah.
And do not buzz. Chest, arm. Try each group, as I said again, as a reflex. Sorry, it goes. See how the thumb goes too far away? You have to watch your thumb and sense it. How it goes, after it plucks one string, it goes straight in the minimum trajectory that it makes. Don't even play the other ones. Play the thumb and set it on the fourth. You see?
Yeah.
There's no reason why it should go when you play the rest of the notes far away. Yeah. Yes. And then it goes all the way to the second after that. That's it. You're plucking the string this way instead of downwards. That's it. Thumb is going to the next string, and in the, somewhere in the, along the way, there's a string that it plucks, but it doesn't pluck it away and it comes back.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a C sharp. Exercise. same melody as you. Play them together. Short. Very, very gentle. We are not working on plucking the string. What we are working is what's happening in between plucks. So the shorter the notes, that means that the sooner the finger has returned to the string. So you can engage, and again, after you engage, your motive, your objective is to return quickly to the string. Mm-hmm. That's a different tone also, right? Because you are plucking in a different way now. You see how projective that tone is? It's not this. It's not this. There's time for that also, but for different type of music, right?
Yeah.
But this, that's what we need here. Could be. But play me again. These three together. Put them on the string. Elevate the wrist slightly. Wrist.
Yeah.
Slightly elevated. Yeah? Push down on the string. Yeah. So you use that weight a little bit. Just a little bit, not too much. And now give me this. That's your reflex. That's your triplet. That's it. Now do the same with the fourth. That's it, with the fifth. That's it, do two in a row. Well, you are doing two arpeggios, right? Because we hear this, rather than... that's better, okay. What I'm seeing here is that the I finger goes in too much like this. So it's using more of this movement than of this movement. So leave it there, and only isolate the I finger now. No. Listen how short it is. Huh? Feel that?
Yeah.
Your extensor is working to stop the string. Engage the string and make the cut. There. And this is why you are talking about the nail shape, right? It hooks a little bit.
Now, yeah,
right?
It's hooking.
Very good. That's a different muscle structure that you are using now to pluck. You feel it?
It's completely.
Yeah.
The feeling of everything.
There we are. Can you hold on to that feeling when you play a triple? Of this.
Yeah.
Okay, you see it? You see how far it goes? There's no need for it. So the shorter it moves here rather than like that. Okay. So revising the technique, you know, so you know when they ask me like how much time do you spend with that technique versus repertoire? To me there's no clear distinction in it because everything is interwoven, right? So we are breaking this down and making it into technical exercises. In this instance, the you know arpeggiated triplets. Okay, this section here, what I want you is not to make this clear cut here, however you are coming from here, right? Because you have... No, that's not it, that's not that. You're doing this fine. What I mean is here. Because they are the same notes. This is very clever what he's doing, how he comes from one set of notes which are the same but arranged in a different octave. And one thing becomes another but are the same notes. Great minimalism. Playing it from there, for example, you have F, G, A, right? So I'm playing these three here. Along with you are the same notes, right? Mm-hmm. So I don't want you to stop here. So play me from here when you play. And then G. need to do this transition. Yeah, so there's no like, you know, oh, here's another section. No, this is just morphing out of it.
Okay.
Slowly. At least that's how I feel it. Okay, well, more or less the same stuff, right?
The only difference is...
Yeah, you have that. I mean, this in itself is just... Right? Okay, so give me this one. Is it easier to slur 2-3 or to slide? If you put 3 down, yeah, you sensed something now, right? I think it is. Right? So, yeah. 3-3. Because you can prepare it. You already have that F here, right? Whatever. And then you go to 2-3 here. Alright? Then yes, here yes. Play me the rest. Yeah. The fingers go far away. Give me the one on the second string. What I want you to do is the following. Look. Both fingers are sort of like the note, rest stroke slurring onto the... Yeah. You have to work this a lot. It's not in the hand. It's in this bend here. Now give me this. Again, we're talking about reflex. Uh-huh. Now give me this. Yeah, it's the hand. Sorry, it's the fingers. The fingers are pulling down, the hand is pushing upwards. Sort of like goes far away. Ah, that's better. That's better. So keep it in. So that the only thing is does is this, not plucks and leaps for the another string. You don't seek it the string with a finger. You seek it with a hand. Each one of those you will have to practice over and over like. That's not difficult once you set the fingers where they have to be. But if you overwork them, then it is like, you know, hard.
Yeah.
So after I apply this, my hand brings it. So the fingers are just doing this. And the hand is climbing up and on a different fret. Right? That's sort of the idea. And so on. Alright.
Thank you so much.